Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to Bradley United Methodist Church, our Christmas Eve service, the 11 o'clock. And you guys made it. You guys are awake. Yes. But welcome. We're so glad that you're here to worship with us tonight, to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I just want to let you know that if you purchase a poinsettia, they're here for you to take after the service. The church will not be open tomorrow. Tomorrow's Christmas, so they won't get any attention tomorrow, no water or anything. So if you have bought one and want to take it home with you tonight, please do. Just come up after the service and take whichever one you had ordered, if you can remember, or whatever it is, however you have it organized. Just come and get a poinsettia after the service. Also, tonight we are going to be taking up a special offering, Christmas offering. Did everybody get a candle for the candlelight part of the service? Okay, great. When you put those candles, there's a box there where you grab those. There's also, that's where you will put those on your way out. And then there's a basket there also that we will be taking up a collection, an offering. And so when you leave tonight and put your candle away, if you would like to leave an offering, you can put it in the baskets on your way out the doors. Also, if you are here tonight and you do not have a church home, we'd like to invite you to come back and worship with us here at Bradley. If you've been hurt by other churches, or just, you know, aren't sure about church, we invite you to come back because we believe this is a place for you. And we want you to feel welcome here. So that's your personal invitation. I don't know if you are attending a church someplace else or not, but if not, please, give us a try. Come back and worship with us. We'd be glad to have you. We will begin our worship service tonight by the lighting of our Advent candles.
We have unwrapped a present on each Sunday of Advent with great anticipation for the gifts that God reveals.
We open our hearts as we open the gifts.
The gift of hope is an essential survival tool because it reminds us that the hard times do not have the last word. The gift of Christ's peace reminds us that we can have peace even in the midst of non-peaceful situations. The gift of joy is not the equivalent of happiness, but rather the deep call to delight in the small things. The gift of love is the clarion call to use as Jesus' disciples. The more love we put into the world, the better the world will be. And tonight, we celebrate the presence of the light among us.
Thank you. with me in prayer. Beloved in Christ, at this Christmas time, let it be our delight to hear the message of the angels and in heart and mind to go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in the manger. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all God's people, for unity and goodwill within the church, and especially in this, our own community. Let us pray for the poor and helpless, the cold, hungry, and oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and unloved, the aged and children. And let us remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore, in a greater light, the multitude whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are one forevermore. We humbly offer these prayers in the words which Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Righteousness from this time onward and forevermore.
The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth, then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. of the earth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. For nothing will be impossible with God. Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The fourth lesson is from Matthew. Matthew tells of the birth of Jesus from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 through 23. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. And now for the fifth lesson. The shepherds go to the manger, and this is in the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 through 16. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all of the people to see. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you, and you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which is the Lord, who has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
sixth lesson is the wise men are led by the star to Jesus, and it's found in Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 11. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay homage.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh." This is the word of the Lord.
The seventh lesson. John unfolds the great mystery of the incarnation. And it's from the book of John, chapter 1, verses 1 through 5, and then 14. "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a God's only Son, full of grace and truth." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We're now at the point of our service where we're going to take our candles and light our candles together. I will take my candle and light it off the Christ candle. And once it's lit, I will just hold it straight like this, and then I will light the usher's candles as they come up. And I will hold mine straight, and they'll take theirs and light it off of mine. And then they'll go to you, and they will start at the end of the pew, and you'll light your candle off of their candle. So the way it should work is, if your candle is lit, don't tilt it. Just keep it straight like this, and the person that's not lit can tilt it and light it off the one next to them. This will help keep the wax from dripping over. So just remember, if yours is lit, just keep it straight like this. And if it's not lit, tilt it over and light it from the person's next to it. And so we'll do that until everybody's candles are lit and the lights will go down, and we will sing Silent Night together as we do that. So if the ushers will come forward at this time.
Thank you.
stand up. forth this night, taking the light of Christ out into this world as a beacon of hope and love and joy and peace. And Merry Christmas to all. Amen.
Amen.